म्यूटेशंस आइडेंटिफिकेशन बाई सॉदर्न ब्लॉटिंग. वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन यूज ऑफ सॉदर्न ब्लॉटिंग इज टू आइडेंटिफाई द म्यूटेशंस और द सिंगल न्यूक्लियोटाइड पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म इन डिफरेंट जीन्स ऑफ द ह्यूमन्स. हाउ म्यूटेशन इज आइडेंटिफाइड? द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ म्यूटेशन अफेक्टिंग आर सिक्शन एंजाइम साइट कॉजेज द पैटर्न ऑफ बैंड्स टू डिफर फ्रॉम अ नॉर्मल जीन. सो इफ देर इज अ म्यूटेशन एंड ड्यू टू डैट म्यूटेशन द सिक्शन एंजाइम साइट चेंजेस, so we can identify based on the change of restriction enzyme site that there is a mutation, and due to that mutation the restriction enzyme will not digest the DNA. so by this method we can identify the mutations in human genes. a change in a nucleotide may alter the nucleotide sequence, so the restriction endonuclease fail to recognize and to cleave the DNA from that particular site. So this is the basic principle that how mutations are identified in case of Sodron blotting. This is the procedure that how mutations are identified. The DNA is digested into small fragments. Once the DNA is digested, then those fragments they are separated based on the size. Then there is in situ denaturation of the DNA fragments. Then this denatured fragments they are transferred to the membrane. Membrane can be nylon or nitrocellulose. Once the denatured DNA is transferred on the membrane, then there is a hybridization of DNA to the label probe and detection of the bands complementary to probe is performed with the help of autoradiography. So this is a procedure that how mutations are identified, because due to change in the DNA sequence, and if that change is particularly at the site where there is the recognition sequence of particular restriction enzymes, if there is any change in that recognition sequence, so with the help of restriction enzymes we can check whether there is any mutation or the sequence of the gene is normal. Estimation of size and number of bands generated after digestion of the genomic DNA will be different, because there is presence of a mutation or there is change in the DNA sequence. So the size of the band in case of normal and the size of the bands in case of affected, they will be different from each other. So mutation can be identified, or the single nucleotide polymorphism, or any change which is present at a particular location, and due to that change, if there is restriction enzyme cannot identify that particular sequence, based on this difference between the DNA sequence of a normal individual and the DNA sequence of a patient, we can identify mutations by using Sodron blot technique.